First World Order Radio. Finally, we are on the air. No doubt. All right.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio.
We get on into some of that order consciousness tonight.
First World Order Radio every Wednesday, 8 p.m.
We got to talk about what is taking place on the planet.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio. First, we need to let you know we're going to be doing more shows, giving out more information on Wednesdays. Wednesday at 8 o'clock, we are now going to make this is the hottest day of the week.
Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns in existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it. Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns in existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it.
You need to understand how magical this, something like this every Wednesday can become. So you need to start getting your calendar right, get your schedule right. You need to know our intention straight out.
All right, so, I mean, these clues are given throughout the various languages was to piece the puzzle of this ancient mystery school back together again.
And what we plan on doing, both of us, is bringing y'all some surefire dynamite. We're going to take this level up a notch. We're going to have stuff to do here. This is not just going to be about philosophies and theories. Shit that works.
We're back once again with Dr. Alim El-Bey. The first song was actually by the children of the Lord's Children of Babylon. The second song was by Bilal and Fiasco Lupe. So tonight's show is going to go into We, the Children of the Sun. We have quite a bit of information to go over, so we're going to get into it right now. When we're talking about Children of the Sun, what people don't realize is that in the ancient Kemetic script, the translation for that is called Freemason or Mesen. And that's spelled P-H-R-E-E-M-E-S-S-E-N. This is where the term Freemason actually is derived from, the English transliteration. But in the Metuneta, Freemason or Freemason means child of the sun, a children of the sun. All right? So, this is where people don't correlate the information at. You know, when people say that, well, Moors can't be Masons, well, that's totally incorrect. Because you are born a Mason as being a melanated being, a child of the sun. Now, this shouldn't be hard to understand because whenever you step into the sun, matter of fact, European scholars and scientists, Albion scientists, have now stated that so-called Moors or black folks need at least an hour in the sun a day. We need at least an hour in the sun a day. They themselves can't take no more than 20 minutes at the max. This is according to their scientists. The reason why you need more sun is because if we analyze the breakdown of the chakra system. You basically have seven major chakras, of course. We go into 9 and 12. We'll be going to stick to the 7 because that correlates to Revelation 1, first chapter through the 7th chapter, or 12th chapter, actually, in which that speaks about the number 7 throughout chapter 1 and through chapter 12. But these are known as the Elohim. They're also known as the Aritu within the ancient Tamarian or Tamarian script, or Metuneta, Aritu, right? When we get into it, you will see how the word Mesen is translated as Mes, or the Hebrew transliteration as Messiah, or the English transliteration as messenger. So actually the English transliteration of messenger actually means a child of the sun. So if we stay in the sun for an hour and the sun is 93 million miles away and it takes 8 minutes and 20 seconds for the rays of the sun to touch down to planet Earth, and us as being earthlings, it takes 8 minutes and 20 seconds for the blood to rotate throughout the body and bathe the brain in nutrients. All right, so hence the head itself symbolizes the image of the sun. Of course, when you become a quote unquote holy man or Heru Nis or Heru or Him Trimajestis, as they would say, you develop that golden disc around your head known as the halo or helios. This is truly when you are a child of the sun, or you are in the image and after the likeness of God, hence Ra, the sun, light, is when you reach that level, actually. But you need melanin as a conductor in order to help absorb the rays of the sun. So it takes, if you have seven chakras and you're in it, and it takes 8 minutes and 20 seconds for the rays of the sun to touch down, then that means that it would actually take 57 minutes and 40 seconds, hence nearly an hour, for the sun to help adjust your endocrine glands or your chakra system. In other words, to help regulate the seven Elohims, who was, is, and forever will be. The seven Elohims are the creative spirits in which that formed your physical body into existence. In other words, these particular chakras were the templates in which that formed your various endocrine glands and in which they help regulate the structuring of your physical body into existence. All right, it's called morphogenesis or morphogenetics, in which it speaks about an ethereal or astral template in which that you actually have formed, in which that has actually been verified prior to your physical body. All right, it's the same thing as with a Curlian camera, in which that was developed in the early 1900s, in which that dealt with being able to see a person's aura, or the prana, or the chi, or the ki energy, in which that emanates from the person's body, whether it's the hands or whatever the case may be. You want to become a child of the light, or a child of the sun. All right. Now, of course, this has been translated by Morals and Dogma by Albert Pike into the worship of Lucifer, who is called the light bearer. But the only one who can bear the light actually is a melanated being in its totality. Whenever you go and do some research and study on melanin, you will find out that it is able to absorb heat, sound, or music, light, rays, various spectrums such as infrared, visible light spectrum, X-rays, gamma rays, cosmic rays, TV, radio waves, etc., able to absorb all of the frequencies. It deals with the Roy G. Biv, red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, violet, those particular seven colors of the rainbow that correlates to the seven chakra system, in which that also symbolizes the formation of your physical existence, because those seven colors are superimposed over your seven endocrine glands or seven major glands in your body. Your pineal gland in particular, your pituitary gland, your thyroid glands, your thymus gland, your pancreas, your adrenal glands, spleen, and the testes, and the prostate gland with the male, and the clitoris, and the ovaries for the woman. These are the seven endocrine gland system in which that produce hormones, what is known as ductless glands. All right, so this is the science. Now, when you get into Freemasonry, Heru is the son of Osset, and of course of Osaw. Of course, Osaw was cut up into 14 pieces, and his phallus or penis was never found. It was eaten by a crocodile in the text. Another text, a catfish, and another text, a crab. In other words, a scavenger of the sea, of the ocean, a bottle feeder. All right. In other words, symbolic to the fact of the desires, lust, you know, greed, envy, jealousy, all of these things was eaten symbolically. So Tahuti had to form him a new phallus or penis, referred to as a tekin. All right? In which that, of course, it becomes the word obelix from the Greek English transliteration. And of course, you see this obelix all over the world, St. Peter's Square, Washington, D.C., et cetera, et cetera. London, those three places in particular, as they have set up government or attempted to set up government based on a theocratic system stemming from out of the Vatican, with St. Peter, of course, you know that the penis is also called Peter, you know, metaphorically. But from this union between Osset or Isis and Osaw, Osiris, once the penis or phallus was made by Tahuti, she was able to transform herself into a bird symbolic to the soul and light herself over top of the phallus in order to make Osaw orgasm, as we would say, in which that from that union produced Heru, hence the concept of the Immaculate Conception. We get within the Bible of the angel Geb or Gabriel, which is a form of Tahuti, comes to Mary in order to tell her instructor that she is pregnant with a child, but yet she was not with Joseph or Seb or Geb once again in that sense, you know. So this is all symbolic, but this is all that is there. Isis or Osset, other name is Mary, which is M-E-R-I. All right, and this has been proven on many stelas or stills of Metuneta and, you know, on the walls. We have those particular stills in which that you can actually see Osset Mary. So they dropped the Osset and made Mary into M-A-R-Y. So, of course, Heru, playing his part, would have to become Jesus. Heru within Masonry becomes Hiram Abiff, derived from Heru's name, Heru Orket, or Heru M. Orket, which is actually symbolic to the Sphinx, who's the initiator into the ancient mysteries. Now, Aten unified, which is Amenhotep the fourth, he unified the teachings of Tahuti, called Haka, which becomes the mystery schools, in which that all of the so-called groups stem themselves from, whether it's Rosicrucians or Masonry. They all state that they come from out of Africa, Egypt in particular, from Akhenaten or Akhenaten and Thutmose, or Tahutimose, or Tahutimis. All right? And both of this is true because Akhenaten unify the teachings of Tahuti, which is called Aten. That sun disk, once again. In particular, the sun disk with the wings in which that spread across, in which that is the top portion of the caduceus or the uraeus, in which that we see, in which that becomes the healing symbol on each hospital throughout the country and possibly throughout the world. That is this symbol in which that is used. Of course, you would see Imhotep also with that particular symbol as being the, you know, the said first father of medicine. You know, of course, he wasn't the first father in, you know, as regard to that. We've been here for billions of years, but he's the first recognized father, you know. And of course, you have different papyrus in which that lists particular medical healings from plants, various animals in which that was actually utilized for the healing process. All right? Various papyrus. Now, these universities that was formed was supposedly to reach the sun umbano, which means the supreme good from which all others are derived. From that particular system, 3 degrees were given to the Greeks or Persians. All right? If you get Walter Williams' book, Historical Origin of Christianity, he states in it that a priest by the name of Sylvester, of course that was not his name, but you know, but that's what he's called, gave forth 3 degrees to Alexander the so-called great brother by the name of Ptolemy. All right, Ptolemy. And he took those supposedly, you know, particular degrees of a 9-degree system in which that later on we get, you know, the 3 degrees in Freemasonry, known as the Blue House or Blue Lodge degrees, known as Inter-Apprentice, Fellow Craftsman, and Master Mason. We all know that the other 30 degrees are honorary degrees in the Scottish Rite tradition. Now, that 33 symbolizes the 33 vertebrates in your back and the 31 encased nerves plus the 2 outer case nerves known as the sacral nerves, which makes 33 nerves. Hence 66. 33 plus 33 is 66. Of course, when you analyze the Bible, you have 66 books. That's what that is symbolic to. And who came to that conclusion, or that mathematical conclusion, of course, is supposedly King James, who was the United Grand Lodge of England Grand Master during the time when he was translating, you know, or putting together his own Bible. Of course, he had Francis Bacon, who was, i.e., William Shakespeare, who was 46 at the time, to translate or edit, you know, the Bible with his Shakespearean council. Various teachers from Oxford and Cambridge and different other places throughout Europe, universities throughout Europe, they came together in order to put together the King James Version. And according to historical facts, Francis Bacon, William Shakespeare asked King James in order to put himself into to actually put his name in the Bible. And of course, King James refused. And according to the signs, if you go and read Psalms 46, hence he was 46 years old and actually made up the 46th man on the Shakespearean Council. You read 46 words down, you see the word shake, and you count 46 words up from the word shalah, which means the worship in Hebrew, and you would see the word spear. So Shakespeare, he embedded his name inside. And of course, throughout those 3 paragraphs, you see the word will 3 times. that is no coincidence. All of that is based on the fact of William Shakespeare, Will Shakespeare, or Francis Bacon actually putting his pen name, you know, within there. All right. Now, the more information that we've come into fact is that we find that King James, as well as also William Shakespeare, they both was Moors. Now, this might surprise some because all this time, you've been just seeing them as Albions or Europeans, whites. But based on the current information in which that is coming out, is proven or is being shown otherwise. And that would account for the fact why a large portion of the Bible still, in a sense, admit that, you know, that we are so-called in the Bible. For example, in the book of Revelation, the first chapter, it speaks about one like the Son of Man having hair like lamb's wool, you know, white, you know, woolly hair. You know, there's only one race of people on the planet that has woolly hair. Why would that reference be left in there? You go to the book of Daniel's, and the Ancient of Days has pure hair, white hair, you know what I'm saying, that's woolly. You know, that's left in there also. So that makes sense on the reason why those particular clues are still left in the translation. Of course, you know that in Genesis, it speaks about the fact of the river running through Cush or Ethiopia, what is known as from out of the Garden of Eden. There was four rivers, of course, the blue and white now, and it is said that portion of that now ran through Ethiopia, or what is known as Cush, and it's referencing to the other two rivers spreading out from the son of Cush, Nimrod, in which that was dealing with the Euphrates and the Tigris River. If we're looking at land, that is. Of course, there's a metaphysical meaning behind all of this, too. But we won't get into that right now. So, when we're looking at this, we have to go back and analyze these particular things. So, we know that these 33 vertebrates, symbolic to Jesus Christ dying at the age of 33, as well as also what is known as the backbone of Osiris, what is known as the backbone of Osaw, known as the Djid or Jedi. Of course, this is the origin of the so-called Star Wars masters called Jedi. Biblically, the spinal column is actually mentioned in Genesis, the 28th chapter, the 10th to the 12th verse, where it speaks about Jacob seeing angels when he dreamed that he seen angels going up and down, you know, up and down upon a ladder that was set up on the earth, you know, and at the top of it, they reached to heaven, you know. So he's seen the angels of God ascending and descending on it. You know, figuratively, this is called Jacob's ladder, but it is the Djid or Jedi, which is the master of the fire of the back, the life-giving fire, somebody to the Kundalini, going up the particular 33 vertebrates through the seven chakras. Hence, symbolic to the York side of Freemasonry, in which that deals, after the first 3 degrees, you have 7 more, in which that deals with the Knights Templar's degree as the highest. So both York and Scottish Rite deals with the science of the physical body. And most of the Masons, especially the lower level ones, don't know this science. So they got something in which that they don't understand themselves. And this is no better than the priesthood thousands of years ago after the Dogons left Egypt, and Egypt basically closed down the real ancient mystery school system, and Akhenaten was attempting to bring it back. You know, the priesthood basically didn't understand that information any longer. And you can find that information in Wallace E. Budge's book. And he speaks about it. I think it was called the Osirian and the Egyptian Resurrection. Right? He speaks about it in there. So you definitely want to go and check out, you know, where this information comes from, because we're not being taught this information properly and correctly. And it's for a reason. So that you won't know how all of this relates. Now you get another book, it's called Blackout Through Whitewash by Dr. Suzor. She writes that the power that causes galaxies to spiral and the planets and atoms to spin, that causes the DNA spiral of the DNA molecule, this same spiraling power causes spiraling hair, otherwise known as nappy, a word for, you know, from actually it's from the word of the nappy, which is actually a Moorish tribe known as the Delaware Moors. All right. Or i.e. woolly hair. It says the basically the word spin, spiral, and spiritual have common roots. All right. The supreme power spins, spirals, it is spiritual. It moves or spirals the universe. The entire universe dances in spirals and rotations. The hair is really antennas that can receive and transmit energy. All right, so this is what she says. And when you break that down, let's look at it this way. We gave this analogy before, that before the TV remote control and cable, TV had channels between 2 and 13, or VHF, very high frequencies, utilizing what is known as the rabbit straight air antennas, which symbolizes or represents the third-dimensional apparent reality, or Maya, you know, which is based on length, width, and height. However, when you reach channel, but however, to reach channel 14 through 83, you got to turn it to channel U, the U channel, which is ultra-high frequency. All right, which utilizes the ohm antenna, which is the circular antenna, which looked like the omega sign from the Greek, which is symbolic to the alpha and omega, the omega symbol. But within the ancient Kemetic metronetta, it is shen, S-H-E-N, in which that symbolizes spirit. So it represents the fourth dimension apparent reality, which is Maya, once again, all of it is Maya, or the illusion, and but this one adds depth to it, D-E-P-T-H. So as we analyze the hair textures from rabbit straight air antennas, you know, to the ohm antenna, that's from the third to the fourth dimension. Now you would know why the various monks of Shaolin, Buddhism, Taoism, and the yogi teaches how to chant the particular ohm sound, to tap into that particular frequency of the spirit world, all right, known as the astral plane. All right, and based on the current heavenly alignments and according to the prophecies of the indigenous people of the planet Earth, such as the South Africans, the Olmec, Mayans, the Hopis, the Aborigines, and etc., we're moving into the fifth world, or the fifth dimension, in which that deals with, which will deal with energy. So we are moving beyond lift, width, and height. We're moving beyond depth, and we're moving into energy now. Therefore, the hair plays an important part in receiving and transmitting various frequencies, you know, such as thought, light, sound, you know, from the cosmos to the from and to the cosmos and spirit world. Especially the woolly hair that curls like the ohm antenna, called the shen, as we spoke about, which means spirit within the metronetta. But even in China, shen is spelled the exact same way, and it means spirit there also. This is no coincidence. So, when we get into that, there's certain things that you have to look at too, in which that deals with various mysteries about melanin and about the skin. and how we can be better conductors. Based on this artificial diet that we've been eating and the fluoride in which that is in the water, which has been known to calcify the pineal gland, the foods are now genetically altered, or what is called GMOs, genetically modified organisms, is found within over 80% of the foods in the supermarkets. Chemtrails are being dropped on us throughout the world. There's a global effort to hide the sun. And there's even reports of nano chips technology in the so-called quote-unquote chemtrails and bacteria spores. So not only does it have aluminum and barium, etc., in order to block the rays of the sun, as it falls, it is also infesting our bodies and causing diseases such as Magellan, which that is a disease in which that is very reminiscent of the flesh-eating disease, and etc., and how it actually melts the organs from the inside out. So, these particular things are happening. However, there's ways in order to get around them. All right? There's ways to get around them. Now, before we get into that, let's get into how the solar and the earth energies are, you know, increase, you know, the DNA and the genes, which have been dormant for centuries, and how they will be turned on, you know. At least for those who are somewhat understand the DNA is and how the genes expression works. The earth vibrations are increasing. Of course, that's the earth resonance, what is known as the Schumann resonance, in which that has increased from 7.83 hertz to 13 hertz currently, and soon 14 hertz. And as it reached 14 hertz, which some places is already gone to, we have entered into the fourth dimension, in which that deals with the dark rift, as our sun and planets come through the dark rift of the photon belt. And once we come out of the dark rift, we'll be on the other side of the photon belt closer towards Alcyon, which is the central sun in the Pleiades, and actually the central sun of the Milky Way galaxy. All right, so that's why it makes so much sense, you know, that these higher energies will play or have an effect on our DNA. And the reason why they are trying to shut this down, they don't want us to have these particular connections as being the children of the sun, because we will graduate to the fifth dimension, leaving those behind who are only third dimensional entities, as well as their cronies, in which that has been using them, these beings, from the first overtone of the first and second overtone of the fourth dimension. We have bypassed them also, in which that these were the so-called gods, in which that the people have been worshiping on this planet for thousands and thousands of years. We'll bypass them. And they don't want this. So there's many things in which that can cause DNA mutation. Of course, we know X-rays, cosmic rays, you know, etc. And there's reports, of course, that there's been appearance of two suns in the sky, in which that has been seen. Now, this second sun is said to be Sirius C, in which that is part of the Sirius constellation. And there's also effects from the star Betelgeuse, in which that is supposedly go supernova, and that is bombarding us with millions of neutrinos. And one of the which is one of the so-called night brightest stars, and as its loose mass indicating that it's collapsing, it could actually run on the fuel and go supernova at any time. This is what is going on with Betelgeuse. right? Or Beetlejuice, if you go and watch the movie, that's what that was actually talking about. So if the star goes supernova, the Earth will be showered with particles. Now, there's already 300,000 tons of stardust energy that comes from the cosmos into the North and South Pole, creating what is known as the Aurora Borealis, or the Borealis, which is the northern and the southern lights. And as this energy comes in, you as a melanated being absorb this. And this is the reason why, for the destruction of the ozone layer. That's the reason why the ozone layer was destroyed. It was destroyed by our sun through what is called solar winds. That's what destroyed the ozone layer back in the 70s. Not hairspray, Afro Sheen, as he was telling us, in which that had monofluorocarbons in it. This is what they told us and is still telling our children today in school, in public school. All right, so this type of shower, this neutrino shower, can intensify all trace minerals or metals of this so-called star stuff, which is made up of the universe. In other words, it literally makes things like gold, silver, you know, and et cetera. You know, so these are the things in which that is taking place. All right, so we have to keep this in mind on how the universe is attempting to help us graduate. According to the Olmec Mayan calendar, this, of course, is dealing with the alignment of the Pleiades. All right, the alignment of the Pleiades with Sirius, Orion and Sirius, and our sun, and the planet, in particular, this planet Earth, in which that, according to particular calendars, will happen sometime this year, or has actually been happening with various alignments astrologically. However, you actually have privilege to seeing this particular alignment. And for the last 30 years or so, we've actually been in the season of this particular alignment. All right, you had the harmonic, then you had the harmonic conversion. You had the grand cross in the sky. All these things have taken place over the last, since the 70s on up until now. 87, I think, was the harmonic. Then in 2008 was the harmonic conversion, the grand cross in August of 99, so forth and so on. But these particular things have occurred and actually is part of our awakening. Part of our awakening. All right. For example, if y'all never seen Baba Phil Valentine, when he speaks on lockdown light code transmissions, in which he tells us about the fourth dimensional beings who are being held in a control, you know, and that we are being held in a controlled prism or prison or matrix by third dimensional beings who did not want the fourth dimensional beings to graduate, which we actually already are. And this is what we've been talking about the hair structure. You're actually already a fourth-dimensional being because the pattern of your hair is that of the shin. It curls in that exact same pattern. So actually, we are fourth-dimensional beings being held down by third-dimensional beings who have contact to other fourth-dimensional beings in which that are thought forms. And anything in which that you think about on the astral plane, which is the fourth dimension, can actually come into existence. For example, fairies, these particular creatures such as the Dromina being, the reptilians, insectoids, all these things do exist now on the fourth dimension. And a person can tap into them the more that they can spread their message to other people, and they begin to pray or they begin to believe in these particular things, in which that gives it power. But we are already potentially fourth dimensional beings because of the hair patterns, of the antennas, of the frequencies that we can tap into. It taps us automatically into the fourth dimension or the spirit world. And we're graduating to the fifth dimension, and they don't want that. Now, how we know this is because of certain things in which that is taking place, too. For example, the sun's chronosphere, which is primarily made up of hydrogen, and the DNA, which is called helix, which is from the word helios, meaning sun. So DNA deals with the science of the sun. And the coupling ionic bonds is made up also of hydrogen, hence forming the chromosome of the cell. Now you have equipment, electronic, called HARP, which is called electromagnetic beam pulse weaponry, in which that can beam into the ionosphere. Hence, in its return, it interferes with your ionic connection, your ability to gather the cosmic information. This is why a lot of people don't even dream anymore, because of this interference. But you have to get your mind above this particular interference. All right? If you can shift towards the back of the head, you can become more lucent. It's known what is called the medulla oblongata, where your past lives are stored, where your memories are located at. This is also what is known as your, if you want a photographic memory, this is also where you would tap at the back of the head. So at this particular area at the back, they also referred to as the mouth of God within the Hebrew and within the Metuneta, the mouth of God, or the mouth of Ra, or what is called as Ru-Ra, or Ur-Ra, which becomes the name Allah within the Arabic. Is the mouth of Ra, which is actually looks like a mouth, you know, or shaped like the mouth, and then Ra with the sun and the dot in the center. That is known as the mouth of Ra, which is talking about the back of the head, which is actually a symbol of Tahuti, the moon deity, or the moon netter, or netcher, in which that symbolizes that particular area at the mouth, at the back of the head. Why? Because his symbol is that of a monkey or a baboon. But then Hebrew, they give that science away on the fact of when you look at the word gup, Q-O-P-T, gup, or cup. It says right there, back of head, copy, axe, skull. All right, so. These are the particular words, as well as also monkey. All right, so, I mean, these clues are given throughout the various languages was to piece the puzzle of this ancient mystery school back together again. So, if you can shift your consciousness towards the back of the head, you begin to have more lucid dreams and bypass the circuitry of this particular HARP system, and actually lucent. You can go and become lucent and have visions. Where if you shift it towards the front of the brain, towards the what is known as the frontal lobes or the neo-mammal brain, you can actually have out-of-body experiences, especially dealing with the reticular, the right reticular area of the brain. Okay, so these are the ways, in other words, you have to know which portion of the brain that you're using in order to go above these particular frequencies. So thus the sun's chronosphere and the cell's chromosomes are intimately connected. It's like external DNA communicating with internal DNA. And it's also been confirmed that DNA crystallized helical structure makes it very sensitive to low strength, but specific magnetic frequencies and wave shapes. So depending on the field strength and components, the effects can vary from rejuvenation to cancer. So with one possible effect being the unlocking or the submission of the junk DNA, you want to unlock the junk DNA. Scientists now are saying that they're getting message codes from the junk DNA that they never realized before because it wasn't happening before. It is happening now because there's children being born with three strands of DNA. And we are supposed to have more than one, three strands to eventually 12 strands, as high as 22 strands of DNA. So these new strands of DNA are actually electromagnetic or multidimensional in nature. So DNA is not just sensitive to earthly electromagnetic fields, but it also responds to the body's soul nature. And the soul nature is the vibratory rate of the etheric and the astral plane or compositional signature. And that deals with the particular soul frequency or signature of their soul. So genetic structure and the soul nature are intimately connected once again. A change in one can lead to a delayed change in the other one. And this is what they're trying to do through the nonsense that they've been dealing with, you know, to disrupt the harmonic connection between the earth, sun, and the human body. So essentially, the third dimensional beings fear losing the mind control or the frequencies in thoughts, light, sound, warfare, through time manipulation and perception over the human populace. By going beyond the extended mind control tools, such as the nine areas, such as economics, education, entertainment, labor, law, politics, religion, sex, and war, they had to go beyond that. So now they've gone into the internal control mechanisms. So they dealt with the water, fluoride, which of course is a mind control agent, and a sterilized agent which was first used by the Nazis. So DNA sequence can be disrupted via the ongoing consumption of artificial fluoride drinking water. All right, this is linked with the ability of the fluoride ions, even at the very low levels involved, to inhibit the enzymes, which are essential to repair the damaged or broken DNA strands. And it's been used since 1945. And of 2004, over 400 million people worldwide receive fluoride water. So this is a global thing that they're doing. And these particular leaders work for these particular entities. David Icke referred to them as the reptilians. You know, I say he referred to them as that. I just simply say devils, based on the definition. But the vaccines, the vaccinations, there's been plenty of reports. Matter of fact, September of 1971, they found vaccines may in fact be changing the genetic structure of humans. And this was actually a study done by scientists at the University of Geneva, who made that discovery that the biological substances entering directly into the bloodstreams can become part of the human genetic structure. Now, y'all might not remember this, but millions of people between 1950 and 1970 were injected with this contaminated polio virus containing simian virus 40, SV40, was transferred from contaminated monkey kidney cells used to culture the vaccine. And you're reminded that the SB40 or the 40-year virus to be discovered in the simian tissue is a cancer-causing virus. This is why cancer is running rampant amongst black folks today, Moors today. Right? This is the reason why so-called black folks got cancer at such an alarming or high rate. And we can't go to school or anything, you know, unless you learn how to get your vaccination exempt forms for political reasons, cultural reasons, and religious reasons. I recommend you do so and don't get your children vaccinated because there's over 54 vaccines in which that they will pump into your children by the time that they go through puberty. And even more by the time that they are of age, if they have to go to college. Right? Another doctor called Wendell Winters, a virologist at the University of California, notes that immunization may cause changes in slow viruses and change in the DNA mechanism. Vaccination began in the late 18th century, and the United States Congress has provided critical funding to the CDC, the Center on Disease Control, for global vaccination programs since 1991 in more than 60 countries. Chemtrails, aluminum barium, as we spoke about, these are forgetful and reflective toxic agents, bacteria spores. They even speak about the nanochips that is embedded inside of the, within the chemtrails in which that we breathe in, in which that is disrupting the DNA. But what is the chemtrails for? To close and control the doorway or the portal in and out. To keep the prisoners preoccupied with their health, you know, and to the day-to-day grind. And genetically incapable of making the jump into hyperspace. It says that the bacteria and the viruses go to work altering one cellular DNA slowly before later being wiped out by the body's immune system. After the illness is eliminated, the altered cells remain and continue to reproduce. Sometimes they become malignant, cancerous. The gene transfer is crude and faulty in the vaccinations, and other times the change are so subtle that the body continues to operate as previously, or so the victim thinks. The easy way to mutate our DNA is through a virus. And in this case, actually, the easiest way to unmutate DNA or suppress it from mutating is also a virus. So basically, the chemtrails then are ultimately attacking our cellular DNA. This is what they are doing. This is what all of this is about. Even HARP, High Frequency Advanced Aureal Research Program or Project, according to a Russian study, DNA can be manipulated and altered by vibratory frequencies, which causes the DNA to resonate. And HARP is an extremely powerful transmitter that can tune into these frequencies. So everything they are doing deals with them tapping into the DNA and disrupting the connections between the ionosphere and the ions within your body, the negative ions within your body, in which that is needed for the functions of your various organs. As well as also the negative ions is what you take in when you breathe, in which that gives your body the power and the energy in which that it needs, called prana, or chi, or ki energy. Amazingly, the word ion is actually from the Latin, in which that means John, in which that means love. So they're attempting to disrupt the love frequency. Now, there's no coincidence that in the ionosphere, where the HARP system is beamed up into, that the ionosphere is where our ancestors go when they leave the physical body. 62 miles to 3,000 miles up above the planet Earth. Now, if you don't believe me, get the book Unk, whose introduction was done by Hiru Samaj, and Nur Unk, Uncle Amen, who wrote the book, he states in there that that the perfect mirror to everything on Earth is actually in the ionosphere. It's like a mirror. This is why when you go to sleep at night, this is where your mind goes to, is into the ionosphere. This is why you can see everything that's on Earth there with your two physical eyes closed and your third eye open, roaming the astral plane. This is what we spoke about before, is that if you have spent 75 years alive here on planet Earth, a third of your life, which is 25 years, would have been spent asleep. Why is that? Because it is to help you gain control or understanding or appreciation of the world in which that you go to after you leave this one. Now, do you have to die to get there? No. This is another point of the science of what we're getting into, in which that we'll form the golden light body, in which that we'll be able to materialize and dematerialize at will, become a pure ethereal, a light being, rainbow or diamond body, as it is also referred to as, on the various levels of stages, the golden body being the highest. Anyway, the next one is the GMOs, genetically modified organism or genetically altered food called Frankenfood. All of this is feeble attempts in order to terraform you. You know, the lockdown of these particular energies, prana, chi, ki energy coming into you, is to destabilize your DNA. Eating is a form of light message code transmission or transference from the sun. When you eat, such as fruits, vegetables, especially green leafy vegetables, the most given light source of the sun is the color green. So when you eat the green leafy vegetables, you're actually taking in basically the abundance of the sun's energy. So, like we said, in the U.S. alone, over 80% of all processed food contains GMOs. Foods such as grain, like rice, corn, wheat, legumes, such as soybeans, soy products, vegetable oils, soft drinks, salad dressings, vegetables, fruits that you don't grow your own or that you don't get from the farmer's market, dairy products, including eggs, meat, chicken, pork, and other animal products, even infant formulas had these additives, additives in it, and ingredients in processed foods such as tomato sauce, ice cream, margarine, peanut butter. You can get a whole list of this. So the consumers don't know what they're eating because guess what? It's not labeled. Matter of fact, labeling is prohibited. Yet the danger is clear. So Monsanto, with these terminating seeds, is attempting to control it. Attempting to control the whole thing as far as our food supply.
Come from Monsanto.
This is what they're trying to do. Control our food supply. Because they know that food is one of the ways in which that we interact with the sun. The water, as we know, has over 4,400 channels, 4,400 channels within water, memory channels. Remember, Masaru Emoto, he did a study in which that by writing or saying a positive thing to water, they froze it and looked at it under a microscope. It has a crystalline or a six-pointed star configuration, a snowflake configuration. they said negative things to water, wrote negative things on the glass or whatever the case was, and they looked at it on a microscope and it looks discombobulated. No structure, no form, no molecular structure whatsoever in a sense. So food and water are the two most essential things outside of breathing, which now is being affected with the chemtrails. So they're trying to get us at all three levels, particularly. Now they get these nano microchips, this nanotechnology, what is called nanotech, is the manipulation of the matter at an atomic or molecular scale level now. They had Professor Robert Winston visited the London Center for Nanotechnology, where they have manufactured electronic components smaller than a virus. And they have actually even created or made completely edible microchips. Now, this is deep. They're trying to get us at all the levels: breathing, the chemtrails, water, fluoride, food, GMOs. What can you do in order to counteract this? Well, check this out. There's some sciences in which that developed in Africa. It was called Ra Shekem, in which that became known as Qigong or Ra Ka, which records the art of dealing and cultivating energy, particularly for health and internal force and mind training and spiritual fulfillment. Now check this out now, because Qigong is actually older than written history. When you see Akhenaten or Akhenaten and his wife Nefertiti standing there in front of the sun, this is what they was actually practicing. This is why they called it sun worship. So on the days, particularly when there's no chemtrails in the sky, get out there in the sun, because they don't chemtrail every single day. Other days when they are chemtrailing, practice in your home, because the all-pervasive energy known as prana chi ki energy penetrates. All right? It penetrates the places, what we think is closed places, such as a home. Actually, the home actually breathes. The house breathes. All right? This is another story. That's some old some indigenous shit that I'm talking about now. You know what I'm saying? But it was practicing integrity. So not only in China, you know what I'm saying, but other great cultures had it. Like we said, the Egyptians, and we said it was called Haka, which is the teachings of light, or dealing with the teachings of Tahuti, or known as the art of mysteries. The Hindu Kush people, or the Indians, practiced it called yoga or union, which became known as yoga. The Tibetans used it, practiced it. You know, it's called the art of wisdom. You know, the Taoists use it, known as the way. So Qigong is excellent for curing illnesses and promoting health. You know what I'm saying? There's a saying that Qigong can cure hundreds of illnesses. All right, now, that's what we recommend in order to practice on a daily basis. All right? It's Qigong, in which that leads you into prana or pranayama, kundalini yoga, naga yoga, as it is called. Since we are the nagas, I suggest that we use it, nagas. It's just that simple. Now, when we're looking at this, we also have to learn how to detoxify, and the herbs that you can use to detox is garlic, in which that helps get rid of parasites, viruses, bacteria. So you want to use other herbs such as onion powder, cayenne pepper, chaparral, yellow dock, red clover, burdock, golden seal, myrrh. All of these particular herbs get rid of parasites, bacteria. even artificial ones. Also, black walnut, cloves, wormwood. Not only get rid of cancer, but get rid of worms and parasites also in the body. You have to take these cleansing herbs on a daily basis in large amounts, as a matter of fact. So when it says on the back of the bottle 2, you better take 10. Because we're under attack. This is warfare. Make sure your ass is ready. This is just how it is. Just the day and time that we chose to come back to. This is what Confucius meant. May your child be born in interesting times. Well, goddammit, these are the interesting times that they're talking about. That he's talking about. Nostradamus, Confucius, goddamn everybody. We in it. Get your shit right. This is what needs to be done. Stop goddamn complaining. Stop all the talking and get your shit right. The water that we need to be drinking, you already know, alkaline water. Water at least 7.4 pH balance, close to your blood. The closer it is to your blood, or maybe just a little bit higher, helps ensure that your blood don't, that your plasma or blood levels don't drop in pH level. And is able to actually detoxify. Your liver is one of the major organs, and it needs dandelion and milk thistle. Your brain, ginkgo biloba, ginseng, guadalcanal. Your heart, cayenne pepper, hawthorn berry, garlic. Your genitals, for the man, sarsaparilla, pygium, sore pimento, damiana, horny goat weed, maca, for the woman, maca, don quai, damiana, horny goat weed. These are the herbs that we need. The food. Of course, green leafy vegetables, we were saying. Make sure it's a variety of colors, such as within a salad that you eat on a daily basis. Eat a multi range of different fruits. If you think that there's wax or whatever is on your fruit, make sure you do a lemon. Wash it with lemon juice. Lemon juice has acid on it, which that can get off some of that, you know, wax, some of that toxic wax. Red apple cider vinegar, also. You might have to resort to doing that, based on the way that the food is. A lot of foods that they still have not touched yet. Mangoes are still good. They haven't touched that per se yet. No more than just putting some of that wax stuff on it. But as far as genetically modifying it, they haven't done it yet. They have done it with the papaya, though. So you want to make sure that you get the fruits in which that has not been tampered with as of yet. Pears. Plums. Peaches. Even though there's some talk today by others who saying don't eat these particular fruits, but you might have to end up eating these fruits based on the limited supply of foods in which that we need to eat or can eat nowadays. All right. Now, You have to learn how to absorb energy. There's three areas within your body to absorb energy. And when you breathe in, visualize the energy going to one of these three particular areas. One is your third eye. Two is your heart. Three, your navel chakra or your navel belly button or right below it. If you want longevity, then you will store the energy at your navel chakra. If you want love, then at the heart. If you want a higher IQ or intelligence, then at the third eye. But when you extract the prana from the oxygen, you want to be able to store that energy into one of these three particular areas. The more you're able to store, the more you're able to rotate through your body through the technique called micro and macrocosmic orbit technique. For the male, you would store the energy at the navel chakra, as well as for the female, you would store it at the navel chakra. For the male, however, you would breathe in, move the energy to the perineum. As you exhale, you feel the energy expand there at the perineum. Then as you inhale, you would draw the energy up the back, spinal column to the top of the head. And then exhale the energy back down to the perineum. And during this time period, you will make sure that you pull up your anal muscles, as well as also your tongue is closing off the circuit right behind the teeth. And you will circulate this energy, what is called a microcosmic orbit, 9 to 18 to 108 times, based on how you feel. For the woman, she would bring the energy into the navel chakra. And as she inhales, she would pull the energy up the front of the body to the top of the head, down the back of the spine, to the perineum, which is the G-spot area, which is about an inch and a half to 3 inches inside of her vaginal area. And remember, she has that area pulled up. You have that area pulled up. And as you inhale, put energy up the front of the body again, to the top of the head, and down the back. Now, these channels or meridians are known as your governing vessel, which is from the head down the back or from the perineum up the back, and your conceptional vessel, which is from the head down the front to the perineum or up. From the perineum up the front to the top of the head, basically. These particular channels, as you absorb more energy, you open the 12 other meridians and activate them, and which that deals with the connection between all of your organs. All right? And you want to learn how to do this. As a matter of fact, a person who doesn't know how to do the microcosmic open and have the governing vessel and the conceptual vessel area open, I don't even recommend them having sex because they can do damage to themselves. So by learning this, you would be doing what's called filling the chi or the cushion of energy, which give you the belief in the unseen energy force. It's not just a belief, it's knowing that there's energy in which that exists. It's still like a magnet. The more you feel the chi, the more one learns what to do with it. When the chi is felt, you'll feel warm, peaceful, electrical tingling currents, or either cool. Usually the tingling begins in your fingertips and your joints. The tips of the fingers and the toes, the soles of the feet, marks the locations of what is called the Jinwell points of the chi meridians, where the chi flows quickest through transition from external to internal. So this is why you have melanin, to bring that chi energy in through your melanocytes. Your melanocytes will act like a black hole. So feeling the chi brings a sense of fulfillment or fullness and the awareness of self-connection with the universe. So this is science also of not just feeling the chi, but also building the chi, as we've been talking about, and storing it within those particular three areas or reservoirs. In particular, when the energy is put within the dantian, lower dantian, known as your navel chakra, you got three dantians. Those are the three dantians that we spoke about. Dantian basically translates to heaven. So you have three heavens. This is the third heaven, as they speak about within the Bible. It speaks about, I knew a man who was caught up into the third heaven. That is talking about the top, the crown or the top of the head or the third eye area. But then the heart and then the navel chakra, which is known as the yellow court. All right. So building the chi actually means refining the chi to nurture the spirit. So the refinement of chi is the condensation of chi, and condensing chi has the quality of basically being able to practice the bone marrow washing, which is known as the iron shirt technique. The Shaolin masters practice this on a daily basis, what is known as the iron shirt technique, which deals with bone marrow, because this is where blood is made from, and which that gives you fresh blood supply. So hence, once again, detoxifying. So the breathing, the fresh chi into the deepest core, the bone marrow, and you what? Exhaling the toxins. So once you learn how to fill the chi, you learn how to build the chi or the prana or chi energy, then you have to learn, now dealing with the moving of it. So after enough chi is built up, the chi can now be moved. So let go of your mind, you know, to open the door to spirit. This is necessary to practice of the spirit, actually, the processing of the spirit. This is the practice of letting go of the, you know, of the spirit, in a sense, refining the spirit into nothingness, called the Wu Chi. It has an empty quality to it. It's also a thing ancient chemists call Shu, or emptiness, or empty, or the rise up. Shu, that's what it means. He's the personification of air. This is where Jesus' name comes from within Hebrew, Yahshua. It's symbolic to the breath of life. Or what, you know, Genesis says, God breathed into the nostrils of man and made man a living soul. So you have Jesus every day. That's your Lord and personal Savior. The breath itself. Matter of fact, your soul is sketched upon the breath, insulation and exhalation. Your whole life experience is sketched upon your breath, insulation and exhalation. Shu and Tefnut. Air and moisture. Centrifugal and centripetal force. Push and pull. Yin and yang. That's what this is. So this is the practice of crushing the nothingness by making the decision to integrate awareness and expand the spirit. Expanding the spirit, you know, give you the ability in order to develop your golden body. What's called a golden embryo when it's first born. Symbolic to that golden disc over the head, as you spoke about. So this is the key to Dantian breathing, is to help heal yourself. And it's to inhale gently all the way down into your Dantian area, which is about an inch or so below your navel chakra, or right at your navel chakra. So as you inhale, you'll pay attention to your chakra, to your navel chakra. And you will sense the breathing energy filling your lower abdomen. Feel how your abdomen naturally expands. If you like, you can put your hands on your belly to help attract the breath there. So as you exhale, sense all tensions and toxins going out the breath as your abdomen naturally contracts. Learn to be attentive to the vital warmth and the vibration of the breath energy remaining in your abdomen as you exhale. Guard it with your awareness. Feel it being absorbed deep into your cells as you exhale waste material upward and out through your nose or mouth. You know, this is the key. It's called Dantian breathing. All right, so this is necessary on removing toxins. Right, there's another procedure, which that deals with activating particular nadis and meridians within your body. It's called the alternate nostril breath technique. What this does is help optimize the creative side of the brain, which is the right hemisphere, and the left logical verbal side of the brain, which is the left hemisphere. So what this does is synergizes both hemispheres of the brain to function properly. And you do this through breathing through the nose. And what you would do is close your right nostril, breathe in for a count of 4 through the left nostril, close both nostrils for a count of 16, and then breathe out through the right nostril for a count of 8, and then reverse, go back and forth. You would do 20 each one. And the yogis consider this the best technique to calm the mind and the nervous system. And it is. And it's helpful for the heart, high blood pressure, arthritis, heart blockages, you know, your cartilage, your ligaments, Parkinson's disease, sinus fluid reduction, depression, migraines, asthma, you know, allergies. That's what this does. All right, so this is necessary in learning how to master. Now, this is why normally every 2 hours or so, one of the nostrils, left or right nostril, is actually clogged up or blocked. And you only breathe through one nostril at a time all day long for 24 hours. 2 hours here, you breathe through one. 2 hours here, you breathe through the other. Well, that shows that the cycle of chi is blocked. That's what that shows. Because there's 12 meridians that are symmetrical on the right and left side of the body. And they are connected with each other. So when one is affected by a blockage, they all ultimately become damaged. This is what happens with the meridian. So chi begins to flow in the lungs. Then it travels to the large intestine. From there, it goes to the stomach. Then it goes to the spleen. Next, it travels to the heart. Then it goes to the small intestine. Then it goes to the urinary and the bladder, urinary tract and the bladder, and then to the kidneys. You know, after this, it heads back to the pericardium and the triple warmer. Finally, back to the gallbladder, the liver, and then back to the lungs again, where it starts its journey over again, assuming that your chi is flowing in a normal way and that you have no blockages. It travels there through each of your organs at a specific time of the day. Like, for example, your lungs is activated between 3 a.m. to 5 a.m., your large intestine between 5 a.m. to 7 a.m., your stomach between 7 a.m. to 9 a.m., your spleen between 9 a.m. to 11 a.m., your heart between 11 a.m. to 1 p.m., your small intestine between 1 p.m. to 3 p.m., your urinary bladder between 3 p.m. to 5 p.m., your kidneys between 5 p.m. to 7 p.m., your pericardium between 7 p.m. to 9 p.m., your triple burner between 9 p.m. to 11 p.m., your gallbladder between 11 p.m. to 1 p.m., 1 a.m., and your liver between 1 a.m. to 3 a.m. This is what all of this is symbolic to. Okay? So by mastering the alternate nostril breath technique, you cleanse these particular meridians. And this becomes necessary. All right, we're going to go and get to the phone line. We got questions. We got area code 347. Area code 347, you're on the line. Peace.
Oh, good night, Dr. Bay. This is Deborah.
Peace.
Yeah, good. Thank you for your wealth of knowledge about, definitely about the whole experience and knowledge of chi and how the body functions, and it definitely needs balance. And wow, it's really empowering to know that. I just want to let everybody know, look out for my interview next week, October 3rd, for the Piper Center for Internal Wellness that offers colonics and acupuncture and air candling in New York City at 73 Spring Street. Thank you.
All right. Thank you.
All right. Have a good night.
All right now. You got area code 314. Area code 314. You're on the line.
That's a brother. That's a brother with the nails.
Peace, brother Al. How you doing tonight?
I'm doing good, boy, brother. Very good.
That's
very good.
Good.
Soaking up all this light knowledge you've given me tonight.
All right.
I was thinking about what you said about the holy man. That can also be translated as sun man, can it?
Exactly. Exactly.
Sun man or holy
sun
people,
man.
Sun people.
Or the son of God.
Yes, sir.
Or as the Bible says, the son of man, because Jesus went by both titles.
Yes, sir.
So when you're the son of man, you know, that's when you begin in this stage as a neophyte. But as you
okay.
become an adept or a master, then you become a son of God.
Mm-hmm.
Or a sun god. because mm-hmm. you've mastered the science of being able to encapsulate the rays of the sun. So hence you become Ray or Ra incarnated.
Mm-hmm.
God incarnated. Exactly.
Mm-hmm. All right. Yes, sir. I was also listening to what did I hear you right when you said about King James with Shakespeare was his code.
Right.
Was a code for King
Bacon.
James.
And Francis Bacon was the head of the Rosicrucians at that time period. Exactly.
Right, and you said both. You said that they were Moors.
They both was Moors. Yes.
Whoa.
Yeah. We're coming to find more information out about that. And we're going to go into more of that a little bit later on. But, yeah, we're going to reveal that information. The Hebrew Israelites has actually already revealed the information as far as King James being a Moor or being an Israelite. And we found some information. We got pictures, actually, of William Shakespeare, Francis Bacon's father. And he's clearly a Moor. So that would only make him a Moor also.
So what about the stories they said about them being pedophile, homosexuals, and
we're gonna have to do more research because actually that comes from one particular book which is called Dirt, and I can't remember the guy's name right now, but it was called Dirt in which that stated that, and that from that one particular book is where everybody got that perception from, and we don't know if that could have been, you know, some type of misinformation or disinformation because they was trying to hide the fact that it was more than which they actually put together the scriptures or Bible or what. We don't know.
Okay.
You know, but okay. That's why we're going to do more research and find out exactly on what was going on because that's what it sounds like to me.
Yeah, okay. This is mind-blowing to me. This is the first time I ever heard about Shakespeare, Francis Bacon being Moors. I always looked at them as being Europeans.
Right. Well, that's how the majority of it. But then you have to question yourself, why is so much information about woolly hair? Why so much information about Judah being being of dark skin or Ethiopia, which is Kush? Why is all of that information still left in there?
Okay.
You know, we have to take that into account. When the European, if they was, you know, pure white, when they have tried to hide that information, because that would dealt with our ancestry, they wouldn't say Jesus had hair like lamb's wool. They wouldn't say the ancient days, which they called God, had hair like lamb's wool, knowing
right.
that the only one people on the planet that has hair like lamb's wool.
Right.
You know, so, you know, we're just coming to the realization that, you know, we got to go back and definitely put more research into it and see what we can conclude because obviously we've been given misinformation and disinformation purposely in order to hide us from our, you know, because, you know, the Bible actually comes from the Ra Papyrus, or what is known as the rising and the evolution of Ra from the Pehem Heru Suit text.
Right.
You know, so that's where it comes from. It's like nothing more than a summary of the ancient Egyptian text, the coffin text, the pyramid text, which is called the Mer text or etc. So, I mean, that's all it is.
Martha Asby put that out a lot in his books and his works.
Right, exactly. Exactly.
Because I was I was listening to what you talking about, how to guard against your health, against all these chemtrails. And all these. Now, the other thing I was also unaware of that I was aware of that water that we drink that it was polluted with certain chemicals
right.
that create disease and other sicknesses, but I wasn't aware that it can also contribute to mind control.
Exactly. Yeah, because that's what happens with the Nazis. That's how the fluoride was actually being able to be used was they experimented on the so-called Jews, you know, as far as for the mind control because it makes you docile. It calcifies the pineal gland.
Oh, man.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I was listening to one of you saying about cayenne is good for the heart.
Yeah, cayenne, garlic, and hawthorn berry.
Okay, cayenne, garlic, and hawthorn berry.
Right.
Lately, I've been taking, every morning, I've been taking, like, cayenne and golden seal together.
Right, that's good, too.
Okay, is that also good for the heart as well?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Okay. You have to do some more, but back to the Shakespeare and Francis Bacon Yeah, that being Moors, man, I really got to get we really got to do some research on that.
Oh yeah.
Well, I'm gonna be searching that, cause that's news. Even most of your most scholars look at you like, what he said? What? No.
Yeah. Exactly.
Man. So okay, I think you got other callers. So I'm not gonna hold you too long. I mean, I'd like to get into more into it, but I'll probably talk to you another time about the rest of it, the subject you were talking about tonight.
Okay.
So Okay, Moab. I'll talk to you later on that, though.
All right.
All right. Peace and love to you.
Peace and love, I. All right. For those that want to call in, the area code is 626-414-3535. That's 626-414-3535. You got area code 773. You're on the line.
Peace, God.
Peace, God.
Peace. Peace, God.
Peace.
Peace. Yo,
peace.
This is Masonry Bay.
Peace.
Hey, I got a quick question. I'm trying to lose weight, God, and what I've been doing for the past, like, 2 weeks is natural organic juice and, you know, with the kelp, celery, you know, from, you know, the local health food store. And it actually feel real good. Is there anything else I can do as an alternative to actually help me lose the weight?
Yeah. I mean, what you doing as far as exercising?
Definitely doing a lot of walking and running.
Okay. All right. So you're already doing everything. But you mean how to lose it faster?
Yeah, you know how you... You
okay.
See the results.
So you said you got kelp, right? You got kelp?
Right. Definitely.
All
right.
Also get chlorella and spirulina.
Chlorella and spirulina.
Mm-hmm. And get pineapple. Eat pineapple.
Wow. Now we talking about, you know, cutting my own pineapple, none of that canned stuff, right?
No canned stuff. You're talking about actual
right,
canned actual on pineapple.
Absolutely.
But you gotta use a knife.
Okay.
Here.
Yeah, definitely. Okay. All right. Yeah, man. I'm just sitting here listening. You know, I'm a prodigy of brother Tahuti up in Chicago. You know.
Right.
And man, you know, we've been going in for about a year now, hard man, building up here. And you know, he got my nationality and everything straight, so I should be sending that paperwork to you guys.
All right.
Down there, you're in Kadir, you're in Queens, so definitely.
Sounds good.
Going in a good direction, you know?
Right.
Yeah, but that's all I wanted, God. I'm here every Wednesday with you, man.
All right, appreciate you, brother.
All right, peace.
Peace. All right, we got area code 747. Area code 747, you're on the line. You're on the line.
Hello?
Yes.
Oh, peace.
Peace.
This is Barrasco. So I got, basically, I just got two questions. I'm talking about the sunscreen. I was just wondering if you had any recommendations on some literature I could get to make a correlation with the moon cycle and the menstrual cycle.
Yes, you can get the book by Jewel and the Lotus by my teacher, Sunyata Saraswati. That's called Jewel in the Lotus.
Jewel in the Lotus.
Right, by Sunyata, S-U-N-Y-A-T-A, Sunyata Saraswati, S-A-R-A-S-W-A-T-I.
Yeah, he teaches Qigong, right?
Exactly.
Right, and then my second question is actually, how important is the lotus position when you're doing these qigong exercises, like these breathing exercises? What is its relevance?
Right. Well, the relevance is that each position deals with energy flow. For example, if you do what is called the hugging the tree technique, which is right at the heart, what that does is strengthen the heart as well as also the lymphatic system. You know, if you move your hands up towards the third eye, doing the hug and treat technique, it taps into the cleansing of the lymphatic system, as well as also of the brain. If you take your hands and move it down towards the dance again, it deals with removing waste once again from the lymphatic system, but now also from the reproductive organs. When you do Qigong, you move the energy, negative energy, in which that is, you know, encapsulated your auric, aurifil, you know, what is called negative debris, or what is called negative bioplasmic energy. You can actually move that energy into the ground. Or into the ground or water or whatever the case is, in order to be cleansed and, you know, by the earth, you know, away from you. So the earth, you and the earth has a symbiotic, biosymbiotic influence or connection with each other. The tree gives off oxygen, you take in oxygen. You give off carbon dioxide, it takes in carbon dioxide.
Right.
So nature itself is well enough in order to help heal us and keep us alive and to be able to keep us in a clear state of mind.
True indeed. All right. Yeah. Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome.
All right, peace.
Peace. All right. Let's get back into the science. This is the breath technique that benefits the heart. You will close your right nostril. Take a deep breath in through your left nostril. Close both nostrils and hold your breath as long as comfortable. Then let out the breath through one half of the right nostril slowly. Once again, let the breath out through one half of the right nostril slowly. This is highly concentrated, so therefore this is only done one time. And that benefits the heart. Cleansing and removing waste from the heart through the signs of breath. Because if you don't know, 70% of the waste produced in the body is supposed to be removed by you breathing. 20% through your skin. 10% through your defecation and urination. You think that by taking a good piss and a good shit that you get waste out of you, and the majority of the waste got to come through you breathing. And most of you are shallow breathers. So you're never eliminating the waste out your body properly. So this is another technique that benefits the thyroid gland and the parathyroid glands. And if you don't know what the thyroid glands are for, they help balance your metabolism. If you're talking about weight loss, learn this technique right here, brother. It produces thyroxin, which is very important for burning up toxins, breaking down and building up tissue. It also controls the calcium and the sex function. So you would sit in the chair straight, as with all the exercises I'm telling you, with your back straight. Use the thumb of your right hand, close the right side of the nostril. Take a deep breath in through your left nostril, then close both nostrils for a few seconds. Then open the right nostril halfway and let the breath out slowly. Now reverse the order and close the left side of the nostril and take a deep breath through the right nostril. Close both for a few seconds and then one half through the left nostril, and then the breath out through slowly. Alternate for 10 to 15 minutes during this technique. This is for the benefit of the liver and the spleen. The liver has over 500 functions in your body. You take the letter R off of liver, and you got the word live. So the liver is the detoxifier of the body, which helps you live longer. So once again, your back is straight with no curve. You take a deep breath in, full breath in through your nostrils. You hold your breath, then you drop your head gently back, then bring your head forward, exhaling through your nostrils in a strong manner. And you do this for 10 to 15 minutes. And that cleanses the liver and the spleen area. This benefits the lungs. This gets rid of the stale air in the lungs. You'll close your right nostril with the right thumb. Take a full breath in through your left nostril. Close both nostrils, expelling breath out through your mouth with the ha sound. Alternating the same procedure for one side and then the other side for about 10, 15 minutes once again. What happens is that after you do these particular exercises, it would be equivalent to 2.5 to 3 hours of aerobics. Just these four basic exercises that I just went over with these tapping into these five particular organs. That's what it'd be equivalent to. 2.5 to 3 hours of you jumping around doing jumping jacks and squats and all these different things. This is called internal exercising or internal power. It cleanses the these particular organs of toxins and poisons. You have to learn them. Very important. Then you have what is called the mana pura breath, which deals with the breath of fire. This is a rapid diaphragmic breathing exercise. Basically, it's designed to cleanse the toxins from the body also and to stimulate the kundalini. So you can sit with your back straight. And as you inhale, your mouth is closed. And by relaxing the abdomen, air will naturally enter your nose and your chest, causing an inhale. And when this practice is comfortable, repeat quickly, causing several quick exhales. And you would do this in a set of 50 with a long, deep breath at the end of each set. And three sets of 50 are usually a good place to start. After a while, you can pace yourself according to what you feel right. So you will breathe in, and as you inhale, your stomach will blow up like a balloon, and then as you exhale, you'll snap your abdomen in on the exhale. And you do it rapidly, like. And you do a set of 50 of those starting out, and then build up to three sets, or however you want to. And that get rid of toxins in the body also. So I'm showing you how to get rid of toxins in the body even without the herbs, and you're doing it through the via the breath. Remember, the breath is the most important thing. You can go without food for a month. You can go without water for 2 weeks, but you can only go without the breath for about 3 minutes or so. So the breath is the most important. And then everything else is secondary and falls into place afterwards. So this is the science of what makes you a child of the sun, is by mastering these particular levels of yourself so that you can actually glow and strengthen your auric field. Another technique that we talk about is the 6363 or 7171 breath technique called pranic breathing, in which you will breathe in for a count of 6, hold it for 3, breathe out for 6, hold it for 3, and do it 99 more times to 100. And on the 100th breath, you would have expanded your auric field from 3 feet to 15 feet around you. And the same goes for 7171, or what is called an empty retention technique. Just simply breathing in, holding your breath, and then breathing out. No specific count, just doing it. You have to learn these exercises. It's necessary. So go back and replay this information over again and get this down pat so that you can really be called a child of the light.
First World Order Radio, finally, we are on the air, no doubt. All right.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio.
We get on into some of that order consciousness tonight.
First World Order Radio every Wednesday, 8 p.m.
We got to talk about what is taking place on the planet.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio. First, we need to let you know we're going to be doing more shows, giving out more information on Wednesdays. Wednesday at 8 o'clock, we are now going to make this is the hottest day of the week.
Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns in existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the room based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it. Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns in existence, an indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance.
Order.
System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it.
You need to understand how magical this, something like this every Wednesday can become. So you need to start getting your calendar right, get your schedule right. You need to know our intention straight out.
All right, so, I mean, these clues are given throughout the various languages was to piece the puzzle of this ancient mystery school back together again.
And what we plan on doing, both of us, is bringing y'all some surefire dynamite. We're going to take this level up a notch. We're going to have stuff to do here. This is not just going to be about philosophies and theories, shit that works.